I can hear the cowbells ringing around us as we get ready for this big, big gold medal match. It's Canada against the United States. 60 minutes of action. Are you ready, says the announcers. I think the crowd is ready. I'm sure the players are. We're ready to go for gold. Canada and the United States at the Bolshoi Ice Dome, Sochi Olympic Games 2014. Referee Topman goes to center ice. And the puck is dropped. Wickenheiser and Stack on the draw. Away come the USA. The puck slaps into the back of Wickenheiser. She was watching Stack very closely, and it bounces away for Canada. Canada then in the red jerseys with the red maple leaf. USA with the predominantly white jerseys and the dark blue shoulders. And a whistle on the play after just 12 seconds. It'll be interesting to see who draws first blood, who looks the most comfortable on the ice. That might be where Canada can take the edge, given the wealth of experience out on the ice. And Wickenheiser, who wins that face-off, tries to get that one back to Catherine Ward, but it's a little tussle in the middle. It's going to be feisty between Kelly Stack and Haley Wickenheiser. That's another little sidebar issue to watch in this game. There's going to be a lot of little cameos, a lot of little stories off the puck, a lot of little personal battles. Here comes Augusta, Megan Augusta with the big shot. One of the personal battles might well be between Megan Augusta and Amanda Kessel, because depending on who you ask, they are both the best player in the world.
Yeah, they'll both have something to prove here today, put a stamp on this. They both want goal really bad, but we saw Wickenheiser and Stack come together. Stack trash-talking Wickenheiser a little bit, gave her a little bit of a cross-check, trying to take the superstar Wickenheiser out of this one early for Canada.
Face off though, inside the US zone. It's Kessel with it. Kessel out there with Kendall Coyne. And those two connect. It really is a thing of beauty. They're fantastic skaters, so fast. And of course their line mate Decker, key component to that trio of forwards. And here they come, shot on goal. Zabados has to make the first save. The effort coming in from Kendall Coy, no real power behind it, quite a comfortable one for Zabados. And we have the first real effort at goal from Canada, sorry, from USA.
Coin, 2 goals, 4 assists in the tournament, a high shot there, good for Zabados to get an early touch, get into this game.
Rougeau out towards Irwin. Irwin, who missed the early part of this tournament with a carryover injury, but she still came out to Sochi. They knew that she should be okay to take part in some of the tournament as they go deep into the tournament. And sure enough, Irwin is out there, has contributed some big moments. Canada have it. Nearly a mix-up between the two. Irwin, though, will just play that out to the right-hand side. Touched out by Fortino. Roulette will fall to her knees. USA have it. And here comes the big number 9, Bozek. Crushed to the ground. First penalty. Referee Topman's arm in the air. And the first penalty will go to Canada. Into the penalty box will go Tara Watchorn.
It's an easy call for Joy Topman there, right in front of the referee, puts a hip and a shoulder in. If you're going to do that, you can't do it right in front of the ref. Women's body checking Tara Watchorn. Good power play opportunity now for Team USA.
Watchorn is one of the more physical players in women's ice hockey, showing just why there. And early stages in what's going to be a tight game, surely. And of course, this might backfire if the USA can score on the power play, but nothing wrong with stating your case early on. That's what Watchorn will be thinking in the penalty box. She was thinking, well, I've made a statement with that hit at least, even if I have to sit out the next 2 minutes. Well,
it's a statement of don't come down my wing because I'm going to hit you, but it's also a statement these teams don't like each other, so throwing down a marker. And there was another one there by Larocque.
On Stack. Stack, though, you feel that she's made of rubber. She always seems to bounce back. Looks a little tipping front of the net. She might have got one as well, and Zabados had to be alert there to get that one away. Stack backhands it down to Hillary Knight. 53 seconds into the tournament, and Knight was already on the scoreboard. The fastest goal in Olympic history. Knight pushes for there, and it's a big shot. Zabadas, what a save. What a save from that shot. And Schlepper got everything behind that. Zabados made the big grab.
And Schlepper got all of her 5'10" behind that. There's the first chance. Here's the second chance. Two great opportunities for Schlepper. What a glove save there by Zabados.
There was not much margin for error there either, was there, for Zabados? It was right at the top of the glove. Interesting opening stages. USA marginally on top, you'd say. It's Heffert out of defence. One of the three players playing her fifth Olympic Games for Canada. This is Duggan. Kessel will chase that one down. Kessel has had injuries, but she had a fantastic 2013. But there were still suspicions about her lower body injury. So much so she was rested for games prior to the Olympics. Shot. Zabados makes a save with a pad. Well, that's edgy stuff here. Another shot. Zabados, another save.
Two chances for Gigi Marvin. Two great stops by Zabados. She's tracking the puck well, which is a good sign for Canada. Defense really engaged on the power play for USA. Schlepper and Marvin, two good chances.
Just 15 seconds remaining on this power play. USA have mounted plenty of offense with the extra skater. The whistle on the play, though. 16:10 to go in the first period.
Gigi Marvin, nice wrist shot there. Ouellette Kern clearing the crease as Decker was trying to screen, and there's the second one. No screen there. Big rebound by Zabados, though. She'll want to control those, contain those with all that dynamic offensive firepower of USA in the crease.
Just 12 seconds before Watchorn returns to the ice. Duggan with the big shots. Duggan played forward in Vancouver, one of the hangovers from Vancouver in the US team. 2010, where she was a forward, still a very important member of the team, albeit now on the defensive line. And Poulin shot. Oh, that crept past. A vital little touch from the glove of Vettin. May well have kept it out of the net, but it was a scary moment for the US netminders. Poulin suddenly burst forward. Poulin's two goals was what made the difference when these teams met for the gold medal 4 years ago. A 2-0 game with Poulin scoring both of them for Canada.
There's hard shots and there's heavy shots. That was a heavy shot by Poulin. It's so heavy that it went through the netting of the glove. But like you said, Vetter with a crucial touch to keep it out of the net.
Interesting here from the US. If you have a chance to talk about it, we will. But it's fast and furious stuff as Rougeau gets it away. But all I'm trying to say is that the Lamoureux sisters out there with Judy Chu at the moment. But it's a chance in front of the net. Another save by Vetter. It's coming in from the right-hand side. Augusta, time and time again, the opponents have got to know that she's going to ghost in from that right-hand side. She's going to come in from the wings. And the ability that Hayley Wickenheiser has time and time and again to find Augusta coming in when you're not expecting it. The only people who seem to know it's going to happen is Augusta and Wickenheiser themselves. But the opponent have got to be very aware of that. Here comes Knight. Knight's down there with Stack and Carpenter. Stack will chase it down to the corner. Stack, the top goal scorer in the US lineup in pre-Olympic matches. Less of a goal-scoring threat here, more of a playmaker at centre as Ouellette comes forward for Canada. She'll need some support. There's a line change, but they're late getting onto the ice. And finally, she has some support just in time as well. They keep it in the zone. 14-14 to go in the first period. There's no score in the opening stages. Both teams are now with their chances. Canada with the early play. USA chipping their way back into it. And USA have had a good period of chances around the nets and good shots on the power play as well. Both netminders have had to make important saves.
Positives on both sides of the puck. An excellent penalty kill for Canada. Another chance for USA coming up on the power play here as Vetter sprints to the bench. A good penalty kill by Canada, but if you're Team USA, if you're Coach Katie Stone, you're happy with Marvin and Schlepper on the points on that opening power play, generating lots of offense from the point.
So Megan Mickelson goes to the penalty box for this. Well, you can't do that. That's why she's gone off for 2 minutes. Whatever you say, Kevin Dineen.
He's not happy with that. But if that happens against a Canadian player, he knows it's the right call. 50-50 play, but Mickelson goes in there far too hard from behind, roughing. It was called roughing, but it was a dangerous hit from behind.
Mickelson, 29 years old. So we see the shot there slipped out of the hand of Vetter just past the post. But Mickelson, very much the poster girl of Canadian hockey. She gets a lot of endorsements. She's on TV commercials all over Canada. She might not be the most significant player on the ice, but she's certainly one of the figureheads of this Canadian team.
Yeah, plays for the Calgary Inferno. She'll sit for two or less now. You saw a look at that heavy shot from Poulin. Good save by Vetter. Nearly crept by. Keep an eye on Poulin. She's been good throughout, Sochi.
Roughing the call. On the power play again come USA. Duggan is out there with Kessel. Behind the net is Decker. Decker, Duggan and Kessel making up a power play line. This is Bellamy with a shot. It falls in front of the net. Nice work to grab it down out of midair, and Duggan put it down onto a stick. Got the shot on, but Zabados unbeaten still. Marvin, 19. Squeezed in front. Bellamy really wants it. Bellamy's tapping a stick on the ice. She's got it now. She gets a shot in. Zabados makes a save. Kessel has it. Kessel around the net. Bellamy lines up the shot. No, it goes to Irwin. Oh, in front of the net. Just Decker just dug it over the goal. And puck possession, though, is very good. Another chance for a shot. GG Marvin saved out of Zabados. Zabados is getting a lot of action. Well, of course, the two power plays, part of the reason for that. Nice work around the net. Carpenter has it now. Bozek shot. Deflection in front of the net, but too far away. Stack got too much on that. Carpenter, Stack and Knight on the ice. This is Stack, the little number 16. Carpenter, Stack inside tip. Penalty now coming up on the USA. Knight was too hard and heavy there. Melody Dayu, Jaina Hefford goes to the ice. Knight will go off now, so we'll have a very short spell of 4-on-4.
Well, Knight heavy-handed there on Hefford. You mentioned Knight off the top, power forward right there, aggressive, takes down the veteran Hefford. But if you're both coaches, there's a part of this you like. You like that you've come out with fire in your belly, and you like that you've been physical, but you certainly, especially if you're Canada, you don't like those two power plays, because look at this. It was just a shooting gallery in there for Zabados. Time and time again, Bellamy, two shots. Excellent screen there by Duggan, and Kessel buzzing in there.
On the power play, shot from Watchorn. Ward and Watchorn are back on the blue line as we got four on the ice. Poulin is out there at the moment with Johnson, the two youthful forwards. Canada shortly back to full strength. Mickelson will skate on, and I imagine that we'll see Wickenheiser on the ice fairly quickly as well on the power play. But the chance goes across the net. Canada return to full strength. Mickelson is on the ice. She was trying to get straight off again, but as she was running to the bench, she saw that there was a chance for USA to burst forward, so she doubled back to make an important defensive interception. Here they come. Canada with the chance on goal in front of the net. Backhanded effort, but it's away by the US. What can Canada now do as they go on their first power play? They have still 1 minute and 20 seconds of the extra skater on the ice. And Irwin out there with Johnson, and Wickenheiser is on the ice for the power play. Here's Wickenheiser now on the red line. Fortino has it. A lot of changes as the power play unit gets sorted out for Canada. They've got what they want on the ice now, with Agosta out there with Wickenheiser and Spooner. But USA have it, and a clearance long and up the ice.
The USA were able to set up on their power play and really put pressure on Zabados in the net, crashing there with Kessel and different players going to the net. Duggan was screening as well. Canada haven't been able to set up now, but they've got, as you said, the formation they want.
Here's Agosta plays it back behind the goal. Looking for the bounce off the boards. Hukenheiser just making sure that everyone knows she's there by throwing her weight around. A little bit of a fist up there. Roulette plays it out to the right-hand side. Agosta again. Agosta down to the corners. Spooner. Spooner really came out of a shell in the last game. Here's Wickenheiser lining one up. Wickenheiser looking for Spooner in front of the net. Roulette has it. Amazing to see Wickenheiser and Roulette on the ice together as USA return to full strength. Amazing because you've seen it so many times before and you're still seeing it five Olympic Games later. On the puck now, The Rock backhanded swiftly and neatly out of defence to Irwin. Away though by USA, we're past the halfway mark of the first period. Plenty of shots for both sides, plenty of work for both netminders. USA perhaps marginally on top if you're looking at the shots and you're looking at the amount of time spent on the offense. But still so much time to go. And as you know, when these teams meet, you just don't know what's going to happen. You know it's going to be a battle. You know it's going to be a fight. You know it's almost always going to be a close game. You really just don't know what's going to happen.
Well, that's two freight trains coming together. It's going to be explosive. It's going to be fun. USA look a little bit more fluid now on the offense. Canada need to settle down a little bit. Get their lines rolling. Roulette had a chance on the power play, tried to force it. Kevin Dineen will want them to take their time and look for open looks and good scoring opportunities.
Mickelson gets that one out. It's Poulin. A lot of times the Canadians are changing lines, giving up on the puck. More important for them to keep the shift short, keep the legs fresh.
It certainly looks like an up, down, and off situation for Kevin Dineen. I guess he's saying in the first period he wants 30, 35 second shifts. Irwin. Fresh legs.
Irwin has some space. But you're right, there's fresh legs. It's what Canada need to carry on doing because they have some youth out there, but they also have a lot of experience, a lot of older players, a lot of players who aren't quite as pacey as some of the American skaters. Something for us to look at when we reach the end of the period is how the coaches have been setting up their lines and how long the shifts have been, how long they've been changing. And we just saw another change there for Canada, whereas USA leave out Carpenter, Knight, and Stack. 7:40 to go in the first period. Knight has it. Backhands this one to Stack. This is good work up the ice. Stack onto the right wing. Good block though by, I think it was Fortino. Yes, Fortino for Canada with the really important. Fortino is such an unfussy player. Really is so effective. She doesn't seek attention. She just does her job so well. And again, such an important little touch there by Fortino.
Well, it was an excellent play. She kept her stick active. She was cycling back on the play, but she kept an active stick in the shooting lane and the passing lane and deflects it away there.
Johnson tries to make the move, but Picard was in strong on Johnson. Johnson, though, such ability, still manages to get the puck across, but there's no one there for it. Now, less than 7 minutes remaining in a fast and furious first period. Oh, it pops out of the zone. Stackline can't keep it in there. And this is a sloppy bit of play here. There's a line change on the bench. Nearly too many men on the ice called. Dineen has suffered from that on the Canadian bench, I think, three times now in the tournament. Canada have been guilty of setting too many players on the ice and receiving a penalty for it. Now, it's getting tough down there. Lamoureux sisters are two of the more physical players. Played all their lives virtually with boys, and they used to have a competition about who could avoid taking a penalty. Not who could get a penalty, but who could avoid taking a penalty.
Well, Monique Lamoureux just ran over Larocque right there like a freight train, and it's, you know, they're not supposed to be body checking, but it's incredibly physical here in the opening period.
Ooh, and that's a huge hit from Watchorn. I felt that from up here as Doug and her head went backwards. She really had the wind taken out of her there. Watchorn says she did nothing wrong. Watchorn says she just stood her ground. Doesn't matter. She's been sent off. She'll be out for 2 minutes. We have 5:56 remaining. It's Canada nothing, USA nothing.
Watchhorn comes across right there. Duggan's trying to get to a loose puck. It's a high hit. And for Watchhorn, her second penalty of the period, which again, Kevin Dineen will be happy about some aggression, but there's a line there, and the line was crossed on that play by Watchhorn. Look right here now. This is off the opening face of Stack, Wickenheiser. Laying down the markers. Wickenheiser comes in. Knight, who's a powerful forward, 5'11", knocks Wickenheiser down there. And an impressive player is Hillary Knight. 3 goals in the tournament. Plays for the Boston Blades. 5'11", as I mentioned. That's a powerful hockey player.
Amazing. The first clash came, 1.5 seconds into the game?
Yeah, Stack got tangled up with Wickenheiser straight away. And you could see she was talking to her right away. Gave her a little shot in the ribs with the cross check. It's going to be a bump and bruise kind of game. I mean, no one's going to be without a price to pay in this one if you want gold.
These teams played 6 matches against each other, exhibition games before the tournament. In December, they met in a series of 6 matches. USA came away winners of that one. Zabados with that stop on the power play. But to say that that was a feisty series is something of an understatement. 2 of the matches ended up in full-scale fights. Touch in front of the net. Zabados with that save.
Excellent screen by Alex Carpenter. Watch the pick right here. Just lifts the leg up. Zabados gets a glove on it. Excellent work in front by Carpenter. Great shot by Knight.
Knight scored after 53 seconds of the tournament. A real blast past Noora Ratti, and you need to shoot well and hard to get the puck past Noora Ratti, the Finnish netminder. Carpenter. Shot from Bozek. It's deflected away by Zabados. Bozek has got a shot as well. And USA continue on the power play. They still have 1:17 with the extra skater. Knight, Carpenter, and Stack fighting for that puck. Schlepper as well. Schlepper knocks it forward. Carpenter will chase. Oh, very nearly a giveaway there by Wickenheiser. And Carpenter had a swing at that one. Bozek pushes that one forward. Bozek will stay on the ice, but Decker and Kessel and Coyne come onto the power play for USA. And a bit of space on this right-hand side for Decker. Decker shoots just past the post. It's kept in really nicely by Gigi Marvin. Breakaway chance, though. Irwin at the other end of the ice, shorthanded, still managed to get a shot off, did very well. Was she held back? Yes, she was. It's going to be another penalty.
Well, I mentioned it's a real bump and bruise game, this one, this clash of the Titans between Canada and the USA. Well, it's been really difficult for Kevin Dineen's side to get going because of all the penalty-killing situations. Here's the breakaway. Irwin, a good play there by Bellamy. There's a such thing as a good penalty. That is a good penalty to not let her walk in unimpeded. But I mentioned bump and bruise play because you've got some of your older players on Team Canada are your best penalty killers, Heffert and Wickenheiser, and right away you're asking them to do a lot early in this game. That could be a factor later in the third period.
No goals, 4:30 to go in the first period. A full house in for this gold medal game. It's Canada and the USA. We always knew it would be. Ward to Johnson, two of the most impressive players in this tournament, Ward and Johnson combining there for Canada. Johnson, such a good skater, 2+2, the 24-year-old in this tournament, the number 6 player to watch. If you're looking for good defense, watch number 18 in the red jersey. Ward, superb Olympics that she has had.
5-on-4 situation for Canada as Watchhorn steps out of the box.
Heffert coming forward. Clearance from USA, who are now shorthanded. Zabados to Ward. Ward gets that one forward. On the blue line, Ward waits for the shot. She's got it now. She'll line this one up. No, she'll go to her right-hand side, Agosta. Agosta gets it back. Plays it to Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser to Ward. Ward shot. goes through a lot of bodies back off the boards in front of the goal, but Knight will clear. Knight then with that goal after 53 seconds. After the game, both her teammate, her line mate Stack, and Noor Arati, the Finnish netminder, said, "She shoots like a man." That's the sort of thing a teammate and an opponent can say about her fellow hockey player. Not sure it's a comparison that you're really able to make, but I'm quoting there. With 2:35 to go, it flashes across the net. Just a few seconds remaining on the power play. As Jocelyn Lamoureux chases that one down into the corners. And she's got the puck. Back to full strength, USA. The pass out of defense, out of the attack zone, though, was not good for Lamoureux. Bozek will... Wow, that was a shot. Bozek, out of nowhere, just wound and just turned and fired that one in. Zabaros couldn't hold it. Too hot to hold. Johnson gets it to the other side of the ice. Shoots it over, but I think we'll have an offside there as Canada's Poulin couldn't quite hold on to that one. Two goals for gold for Poulin in 2010. Just one over here. Returned in December after a long-term injury. Part of this Canadian lineup led by Kevin Dineen. Important that Melody Davidson, a 2010 head coach for Canada, the gold medalist in Vancouver, is the general manager of the Canadian side. But Kevin Dineen, tell us a little bit about him.
Well, long time NHLer, both player and coach. Over 1,100 games in the NHL, 355 goals. Two full seasons behind the Florida Panthers bench, 16 games this season before coming to join Team Canada, of course. Katie Stone, 378 victories in NCAA hockey with Harvard. An absolute wonderful hockey mind, Katie Stone, considered amongst the best in women's hockey. A couple of observations. It's a bit back and forth right now, but the USA has carried a little bit of the play on the back of some of those power play opportunities, and they've looked really good on the setup. Again, I want to go back to the fact that you're asking Wickenheiser and Heffert, some of the older Team Canada members, to pull double duty, double shifts early on here to kill those penalties. So Kevin Dineen will want some discipline as this game moves forward.
2 minutes remaining. Both teams with power play opportunities. Both netminders have been busy. We've had 17 shots in the game, and here's the 18th, and it's deflected away by Zabados. The netminders have had such a lot to do, and the quality of shots has been high, and Johnson plays that over to the right-hand side. It's one for LaRocque to get up the ice, but Coyne plucks it out of the air, and here come the USA. Now they'll wheel around and look for a line change. Duggan chases it down, but Canada come away with it. Nice work. Good shot from deep on the left-hand side. You think about shots coming from that sort of angle and not going to trouble the netminder, but when they got that force and accuracy, well, Vetter still has to be sharp.
Here's Coyne to Decker. Nice shot there. Big rebound again. Comes out. Kessel lurking there. Here's Spooner. 5'10". Strong player, and you're right, but not only is it a hard shot there, but it's through a screen. Spooner's got two goals in the tournament, very dangerous, number 24 in red.
Dayu getting some ice time now, number 15 on the face-off. Shot over the bar, this is Catherine Ward. Ward gets it into the danger zone, it's away by the US as we go just about into the final minute of the first period, which has seen 11 goals from the USA, 8 for Canada. But maybe a chance here, a giveaway in front of the net. There wasn't much that Jenny Wakefield could do there. She was on her own, but she twisted and turned and got her shot off. Decent effort.
Jennifer Wakefield looking for her first goal of the tournament, just an assist to show so far. But the Toronto Fury's player spins and fires right there. Jesse Vetter with an excellent save.
Wakefield has been sort of moved down the lines during the tournament. She started off, she was a top line forward at the beginning of the games. She was given some chances in the earlier games against perhaps slightly less tough opposition. Still though, it's important to have depth all the way through your lines. You can't risk going into these games without getting production from your third and fourth units as well. Although so much always expected of your top two lines, especially in the women's game, when there sometimes is less strength and depth in some of the other nations. But Canada and the US setting out good hockey players all the way through. Dying seconds of the first period. Could we have one more attack on goal? No, Jenner will just let that one go. And US have it with Knight. Knight tries to use the boards, tries to get past, but Johnson was in there, coming back to help out the defence. Good work from Johnson to Larocque. Larocque plays it forward. Poulin makes a little touch on it. There won't be any more chances after that, but that wasn't too far away. Right on the buzzer to the opening goal. So what a first period we've had. It's been breathless stuff. The netminders have had to be very sharp indeed, as we have now played 20 minutes of the gold medal game, and Canada and the USA are tied at nothing. Referee Topman gets us underway then for the second period. And USA with Carpenter coming forward there, trying to slide it into the middle, but Wickenheiser emerges with it. Wickenheiser enjoying the nice clean ice out there. Looking for Spooner. Spooner cuts back and Agosta's in the middle. That's going to be away by Schlepper. Schlepper to Knight. Chipped out, chipped back in by Watchorn as the Canadians manage to get a line change in, and USA come forward with Bozek. Shot, big shot from Knight, spilled, and Knight hurries after that one, tries to get her own rebound, battles with it so well with Stack. Stack's a player, it's just great to watch her. She's such a hard worker. She may be a head taller than some of her opponents, but she's never shies from getting stuck in there, and her good battling behind the goal there helped keep the puck in the zone, at least for temporarily. But now, big burst up the ice for Ward, and a whistle on the play. Hefford goes down, and a little bit more of a battle than we perhaps thought there was going to be, as Hefford went down and the glove came spiraling off.
Knight again with a heavy shot. Good rebound control by Zavados. Important to point out that Kendall Coyne is out there for Team USA number 26, so if there's a bit of a slight injury, she's going to give it a goal here.
It's important for USA that Coyne and Kessel stay out there, that they are so important, their speed. But as Aaron pointed out, Coyne used sparingly in the first period. Didn't get any, certainly didn't get much, if any, power play time. As Decker, Duggan and Kessel were a forward line used on the power play. It's a big shot from Bellamy, playing a 100th game for USA in this gold medal match. Number 22.
These are two big, strong physical teams. Canada, average height 5'8", average weight 157. The USA, 5'7" and 154. It's been a physical start to this one. And of course, Kendall Coyne only playing 242. A couple of hits in that first period. So you can see the players have already taken a toll on some of them as the physicality notches up here with gold on the line.
The twin sisters, Jocelyn and Monique Lamoureux on the ice. Picard has it. Picard into the captain, Megan Duggan. Here comes Duggan. She's got a step climb beside her, but she's found Stack. Stack inside to Lamoureux. Puck nearly squeezed its way back to Stack, but Canada come away with it with Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser with a shot. Oh, not for the first time. Jessie Vetter letting one slip. Now, on both occasions, she's got enough on it to deflect the puck past the net, but potentially some embarrassing drops there from Vetter. And I was just watching her. The play continues down the other end, but I looked back at Vetter and she nodded her head in sort of frustration. She knows she should have got more on that. Here she goes. She's got that one into the gut. And a little bit of a battle afterwards. But Vetter, a couple of chances there that she probably should have got hold of a bit more.
Well, in the first period, it was a heavy shot by Poulin that she got, let skitter across. That's a good control there on the rebound by Agosta. But the shot you were talking about, the high shot, again, it seemed to go through the webbing of the glove and nearly bounce down into a dangerous area. She's going to want to squeeze those, settle down, keep those rebounds under wraps as Team Canada crash the net.
As we had 4 years ago, it's Vetter against Zabados. Zabados started the tournament in Vancouver as third choice for Canada. She moved up through the power rankings to take charge of the net, and she hasn't looked back. She's been the favourite through the big gold medal matches at World Championships down the years. Zabados in goal for Canada, making some great saves. Vetter looking a little less assured at the other end for USA so far in this game. There's 16:47 to go. We have no goals.
Seven members of Team USA play for the Boston Blades, so there's a lot of familiarity out there which could stand to the USA as this goes on, because more familiarity, the better, as lines get changed around and penalties need to be killed, so keep an eye on that as well.
Bellamy to Coyne. Coyne leaves it to Decker. Coyne to Kessel. Kessel is stopped from going too far. Watch on, I think it was all over it. Oh, it's just in front of the net. Ooze from the crowd. That one just goes past for USA. Bellamy, Zabados makes the good pass out of goal. And this is Hefford. Hefford, Apps will chase this one down to the back, but Picard plays that one safely out of defence, and Bellamy gets it forward to Coyne. Coyne looking to come off the ice. The Lamoureux sisters out there at the moment doing the puck chasing. But Canada have possession, it's Dayu. Dayu for Wakefield. Neither team managing to string much together at the moment.
Looks like Coyne has taken a regular shift in this second period for Team USA, so that's a great, great bit of news for Katie Stone and for USA hockey fans. 2 goals, 4 assists so far in the tournament. Couldn't afford to lose her offensive abilities.
Not much of a rhythm so far to this second period. Plenty of turnovers for both sides as we look at Canada's route to the gold medal game.
That was a bit an exciting game, that 3-2 win against the USA in the round robin. So a little bit of confidence for Canada coming into this matchup. But the USA, the reigning world championships, they actually beat Canada in Canada, 2013 world championship. So they've got that.
Irwin. Ward. Blocked by Megan Duggan. Scrappy stuff at the moment. Neither team really managing to string anything too nice together, but the pressure coming from Canada, and Irwin will knock that one off the boards. Gets a nice, kind bounce for the shot on goal from Watchorn. Watchorn has it again. It comes back to her. It's going down towards Irwin. Irwin and Picard will meet in the corner. Lamoureux tries to backhand it out of the zone. Ward goes tumbling down. This is Agosta, but she loses control. So many turnovers in the opening part of this second period. Still goalless. I feel that the first pretty piece of play will give us a real clear-cut chance on goal, but hasn't come just yet. Bozek brings it down and beats it forward. Hillary Knight, push on the back there of Alex Carpenter after the whistle. We'll restart with a face-off, but neither team really quite clicking in the opening stages, Aaron.
Yeah, a lot of bouncing pucks. The defenseman activated into the play. Catherine Ward actually made a really dangerous pinch in there on Monique Lamoureux. Nearly cost her. Luckily, Lamoureux came down and fell as she tried to go around Ward. There's the results for Team USA, that one loss to Canada in the round robin. They were sensational in the semifinal against Sweden. 70 shots on goal in that win.
It's funny how USA have probably overpowered the smaller nations a bit more than Canada have managed to in the group stages. And yet when they met, in spite of the US having the best of the opening, a superb third period and a real morale-boosting victory for Canada. It meant nothing in terms of points. They were already both through, but it meant everything in the world to the players on the ice to beat their old rivals, albeit in round-robin play, and all being it really kind of meaningless because they were both at that stage already through to the semifinals.
Canada needed that win, as mentioned. They lost on home soil at the World Championships, and in pre-Olympic games, various exhibition games, USA had the better of Canada, so that was an important win for Canada in the round robin, just to get their head in the game coming into this gold medal final, because previous to that, USA had all the bragging rights.
There's the black coat the famous black coat that she gives after each game. She must have a massive suitcase of them. After each game, she gives her black coat to her player of the game. So she must have brought over, well, she'll have five. She must have brought five over here, plus one she's got to wear herself. Six black coats for Katie Stone.
I'm sure the players, the younger, stylish players, must love that. Long black trench coat from the coach.
Who will she be giving the black coat to today, I wonder? Canada, though, coming forward, looking for the opening goal of this gold medal game. Another player goes flying behind the net. Hefford has it. This is Johnson. Johnson digs that one back to Poulin. A penalty coming up again. Oh, that's just past the post by Canada. There's going to be a penalty on the USA when we stop the game, but Johnson still has it. Canada putting some great pressure on now. USA will go shorthanded, but not until they touch the puck or that there's a whistle on the play. Rougeau goes to the ground. Poulin will scrap for it, but now referee Topman blows the whistle. Carpenter gets the touch and will go to the power play for Canada.
The physicality is really notching up. And Schlepper absolutely ran over Rebecca Johnson behind the net. And again, a bigger player taking advantage of a smaller player. Give Johnson credit, she bounced back up like a spring. But for Team USA, it's going to be a penalty kill situation as Kelly Stack will sit for hooking. A great opportunity for Canada. Shots on goal, 12-12. USA had the better power play in that first period. There's the hook. Easy call for Joy Totman. But USA had the much more organized, the much more set up power play in that first period. Canada's going to want to get something from their power play, get into this game, get some confidence of their own with the player advantage. And you see Ouellette and Duggan, the captains, having a word with Joy Totman about the physical play. A lot of big body checks going on. As I mentioned, Schlepper just ran over Johnson, but it's the hooking call on Stack, the penalty of consequence.
From the face-off then, Canada on the power play, Wickenheiser. Spooner in front, Augusta, what a chance that was for the number two. Augusta couldn't put it away. She won't get many easier chances to do so. Vetter with the save. Julie Chu, the veteran from Salt Lake City, out there on the penalty kill. What a player Chu has been down the years. What a servant to women's ice hockey as well. And still doing it for the USA, albeit as a spare forward now and in special teams. Wickenheiser. Burst to the net by Ouellette. Augusta. Big bounce off the boards. Nice clearance, in fact, by Picard, I think, got the puck out of defence. 11:50 remaining in the second period. 1 minute left on the power play.
That's a smart move by Coach Katie Stone to put Julie Chu out on the penalty kill like that. Julie Chu plays for the Montreal Stars, so she knows some of these star forwards for Team Canada, so she knows how to go about her business on the penalty kill there. So a really smart move by Stone to bring Chu out on the penalty kill.
Here come Canada with 14-0, nice time leader. Johnson touch in, Hefford. Hefford, Johnson and Poulin throughout the tournament have been such a threatening line. I really like the way these three link up, the two youngsters either side of Hefford, the veteran. And they're out there together on the power play now, but the time is ticking against them. They'll be shortly facing a full strength American lineup, just 10 seconds left, and USA have the puck down the Canadian end. Here they come again, though. Long shift this is on the penalty for Johnson. Johnson and Poulin combining. Poulin lays that one back. USA back to full strength, but that shot just goes past the post. The effort on goal came from Megan Mickelson. Mickelson again. One to chase. 10.5 minutes to go. We're at the midway stage of this game and still no goals.
What a save by Vetter. Sometimes you need your goalie to be your best penalty killer, and right here, Vetter is the best penalty killer for Team USA. Augusta all alone. Excellent cross-the-grain pass there through the crease. Augusta all alone. Vetter goes big in the butterfly, keeps the puck out.
I was rather blaming Augusta for the miss there, but the replay really shows us how well Vetter did recovering her goal. She was giving Augusta a glimpse of goal, but she was so quick to get over the other side to snub out the play.
She went post to post in the blink of an eye and took away that one-time chance. And as you say, Augusta considered by some to be the best player in women's hockey. Some think it's Amanda Kessel. Augusta right there. If you're Team Canada and you said you'd have her alone in the crease like that, you'd probably put the mortgage on it that she'd bury it. Vetter had other ideas.
Augusta was outstanding in Vancouver 2010. Leading scorer in the Canadians Women's Hockey League last season. 3 goals so far in these Olympic Games, and back on the ice now with Wickenheiser and Spooner. Here she is on the puck, the number 2. Good work. She's trying to pick out Wickenheiser on the near post. Carpenter down the other end. Shot in from distance. Zavados makes the save.
That was a smart play by Augusta there. She puts a low shot in as the ice crew come out.
Vetter just doing some stretching down there. Vetter has a couple of hairy moments, but recovered to make that great save. That will make her feel a lot better. There's a big shot in from the left wing. USA have had a no-fun attitude, they say. They're not here as tourists. They haven't been going out to watch the men's games as some of the other teams have been doing. They said in Canada we had too many days off. We went around taking photographs more than concentrating on it. But us, our fun here. Our fun here is represented by a gold medal, not about being tourists and taking photographs.
Well, that's just a great philosophy, and that's Katie Stone. 378 victories behind the Harvard bench. You don't accumulate that many wins, rather, in NCAA hockey without having a business-first approach, and Team USA all business here. That sequence before the break, the ice-cleaning break, fantastic play by Augusta. A low shot, trying to find Wickenheiser down low, trying to find a tip, trying to find something down low, as Vetter has been good up top.
9:44 to go in the game. Picard backhands that one in. Picard and Pucci out on the blue line at the moment. These two, Picard and Pucci, have patrolled that blue line a lot in this tournament. Not so much in the first period, but you reunited a lot in this second period. That two very, very solid defensive duo, Picard and Pucci, seem to have always been out on the ice together. Chance in front of the net. Vetter makes the low save. Johnson, who had that effort on goal just a few moments ago, still on the puck, tries to get it to Hefford. Poulin has to try and come in. No, it's Megan Mickelson, in fact, who keeps the puck in the zone. So some really heavy challenges along the boards before the puck finally comes free, and it's Kendall Coyne coming forward, the man to Kessel. Kessel will carry on chasing it. Coyne will go to the side, and we'll have a line change as USA send out the Lamoureux sisters again. Steckline with the challenge there. Schlepper, as Decker has it now. Decker out there with the Lamoureux sisters at the moment. Lamoureux sisters so physical, but such skill as well. Fry is on the ice. Very rare appearance for Fry, who gets taken out by Monique Lamoureux as the puck is given over to Ouellette. But Fry out on the ice, another one of the spare forwards for USA, used very infrequently. But a stat about Fry is the first native of Arizona to play in an ice hockey tournament, men or women, in the Olympic Games.
Yep, Harvard player as well, so a smart cookie. This is an excellent play down low again. Here's the big hit. Monique Lamoureux comes in, takes out Ouellette. Give Monique Lamoureux plenty of credit for a highly skilled player, not afraid to get into the rough stuff. Big hit there on Ouellette.
Duggan just chips that one away. Ward will gather, plays the backhand. Jocelyn Lamoureux, number 17, coming in from the left-hand side. Duggan now has it. Duggan shoots and scores. It's 1-0 USA. Megan Duggan. Her first goal of these Olympic Games, and what a big goal it was. Lamoureux created the forward rush. It popped back to Duggan. Top right-hand corner. Zabadov must have had something in front of her. She must have had bodies in the way. She didn't make a great move on the goal, but let's have another look.
Ward couldn't get it past the neutral zone. Picks the top shelf right there. Traffic in front. Excellent shot. Seeing eye shot, top shelf. Watchhorn trying to take out the crease. And you see what that means to the USA women's bench. An absolutely wonderful shot from Duggan. Catherine Ward had a chance to end around play up the boards. Got it only out as far, just outside the blue line. Need a hard out right there with Duggan charging.
Canada coming straight back from the faceoff with Wickenheiser. Trying to get back in this game straight away. But first blood goes to the USA. The goal at 31-57. Megan Duggan. The captain of the USA. Leading by example. Bellamy. Well, it took a long time coming, but when it came, Megan Duggan, Jocelyn Lamoureux giving the assist on it, rightly so. Megan Duggan fired in a cracking opening goal.
Lamoureux does some of the hard work there. Duggan picks the shelf. An absolutely perfect shot. She had less than a foot square to put that puck up top shelf over Zabados, who's been very good, just didn't see it.
All 5'8" of Zabados as well, so she blocks a lot of the goal. Unsighted on that, though, surely, as there was so much in front of her. She didn't seem to flinch as the shot came in. A great shot, though. And 1-0 USA, 7:22 to go in the second period. Zabados was tumbled there. She won't have liked that. It's sort of unwritten rule in hockey, you just don't touch the netminder, but yeah, I'm sure that there's an occasional sly little checks and touches to make sure that the netminder is bothered as much as possible, as much as they can do so within the rules, of course.
Well, there was the look from Zabados there. Take a number. Remember that the next time someone comes through the crease, a little how do you do with the stick. Zabados comes out. Good play there. Takes a hard hit from Kelly Stack. Aggressive player at only 5'5". Kelly Stack not afraid of anybody. And there's the captain. Her first goal is Sochi. You need your captain to lead by example. She was goalless. There's Stack taking out Zabados.
Stack, one of the generation inspired by the U.S. gold medal victory of 1998. Knee injury in 2012, returned in 2013 to show fantastic goal-scoring form. And a bit of a conversation going on between the officials and the captains out on the ice.
Now goes back to Stack taking out Zabados there. Team Canada asking for a clarification. Topman, you can see, she wants play to go on because it was all going USA's way. Duggan, the goal scorer. Perfect shot, an absolutely perfect shot by Megan Duggan. And what a time to get your first goal.
Let's have a look at this. Johnson there. Gets the puck tangled up.
Puck stuck in her skate there.
I'm not quite sure why this conversation is going on quite so long.
Yeah, but there's no way it was too many men on the ice or too many players on the ice because there's a front of the USA bench touched by a Canadian player.
A long discussion going out on the ice between the captains and the officials.
Kevin Dineen, not much he hasn't seen in hockey. He's got the whiteboard out.
Well, I think we've got a too many men on the ice call here. Let's have a look. Maybe that's what it was all about. It was. Well, I didn't see it, but looking at the long conversation, there had to be something that they were taking so long to decide.
A puck looked like it was stuck in the rocker of a Team Canada player's skate.
Johnson. Well.
So Team USA was arguing they didn't know where the puck was.
Yeah.
And they would have had that buffer zone of 5 feet to make that change, but the puck was right there in the skate.
So that's why the conversation went on. Whatever the outcome, after a fairly lengthy debate, is a penalty on USA for too many skaters on the ice. Shot just past the post from Johnson. Watchorn gets that one back to Fortino. Big blast. That's from Poulin. Poulin playing the point at the moment. Over the glass behind, and Heffer tries to key it up in front. Poulin jumping and patting it down. What have Canada got on this power play then? Hefford touches it back to Poulin. Poulin, the 29. This is Watchorn. Penalty coming up on Schlepper. Hefford went down. Shot on goal. Poulin. Hefford. Six skaters now on the ice for Canada. When USA touch the puck or it goes into the back of the net, we'll have a whistle on the play and another penalty. Poulin just didn't quite get enough on that one, but it's still alive. Schlepper makes the high stick interception. And another penalty against USA. Here's a great chance. 32 seconds of 5-on-3 for Canada.
Canada looking good. The 5-on-4, Schlepper. And you can see the arm of Topman was up straight away. Absolutely the right call, taking down Jayna Hefford in front. And Schlepper's been physical. Probably not the time to take a cross-checking call right in front of your own net. The puck going the other way and the referee right in the sight lines. 5-on-3 situation for Kevin Dineen's Canadian side. The perfect opportunity, trailing 1-0.
Schlepper, the 24-year-old, the defenseman, just 5 of the 7, or just 2 of the 7 U.S. defensemen, part of the Vancouver team. 5 new faces on the defensive core for the U.S. The veteran, Julie Chu, is out on the ice for the penalty kill. There are only 3 U.S. skaters at the moment, but one of them makes a vital clearance out of defense. Jocelyn Lamoureux. Wickenheiser. Still Wickenheiser. Takes it deep. Poulin. Ward looks at carving something up. Nice work around the net from Canada. Big shot comes in, blocked by Gigi Marvin. 4 players now on for USA. Augusta's cross-ice pass goes through everybody, right out to the boards on the far side. Back in front and out of the zone. That's careless by Canada. They'll eat up some of their own power play seconds there. 1:05 remaining on the power play. Here comes Augusta. Good burst forward. Augusta goes to ground. Lining up the shot, Ward. Roulette. Augusta, but battered away and out of the zone by USA. Good penalty kill by the Americans. Straight away up the other end and a chance on goal. Well, there are some hits going on the ice out there in this gold medal game. Spooner looks for a wraparound opportunity. He's not quite there. She'll go to Fortino. Fortino lines this one up. Gets it back, good passing around the net. Chance, half chance, but battered away. 4 minutes to go, 20 seconds. We're in the second period, 20 seconds on the power play. And again, it's cleared by USA, or it's careless work by the Canadians as they let the puck slip out of the offensive zone as USA will shortly return to full strength. And Canada not really offering too much as USA return to full strength. That was a great opportunity for the Canadians to get back in this game. They had that little spell of 5-on-3, then the power play, and, well, some hits going along on the boards. This game, well, neither team really letting up at all here.
Excellent 5-on-3 penalty kill for Team USA. Gigi Marvin with a big shot block, and then a big shot block by Jocelyn Lamoureux, which turned her away and nearly had a partial breakaway on the shorthanded play.
USA have it. They lead 1-0. 31-57 when Megan Duggan blasted in the puck after great work by Jocelyn Lamoureux to cut down the ice and create the space. It's going to be an icing here, so we'll bring it all the way back. Less than 3 minutes to go in the second period. Canada letting a really good opportunity slip by there.
Absolutely, and you see, here's the block by Lamoureux. Excellent block against the hard-shooting Catherine Ward. Turns it into some shorthanded offense. Good save there by Zabados, but a prime opportunity goes by the wayside. 5-on-3, and that gives momentum back to Team USA. They'll be feeling pretty good about themselves to kill off a 5-on-3 situation against a high-octane power play.
This U.S. team, young and talented, so much speed. A lot of changes since Vancouver. Not an especially heavy build-up to the Olympics either as well. They took it a little bit easier than the Canadians did in the build-up. They had that series, a six-match series against Canada, but otherwise they concentrated on training camp, concentrated on inter-squad scrimmages and didn't have such a grueling schedule leading up to the games. We have a scoreline with 2:35 to go in the second period of Canada nothing, USA one. One of the veterans in the Canadian outfit, Jaina Hefford. She's been part of a very impressive line with Johnson and Poulin. A lot expected of Hefford, one of the veteran leaders on this team.
5'4", plays for the Brampton Thunder, a goal and two assists so far in Sochi. One of the players, Kevin Dineen, the head coach of Team Canada, will be leaning heavily on, along with this woman, Haley Wickenheiser, 2 goals, 3 assists, 18 shots in the tournament. Never seems to get old, never seems to lose a step. Fantastic servant for Canadian hockey, but more importantly, a fantastic representation of women's ice hockey the world over, Haley Wickenheiser.
And people were saying of Wickenheiser, weren't they, before this tournament, that she's had a couple of bad seasons in terms of injuries. She's really struggled. She's obviously now 35 years old, but just look at the stats of this tournament. I mean, you watch her on the ice, you can see that she's still being very effective, but look at the stats as well. Look at the record books, 2 goals, 3 assists for Haley Wickenheiser, but they need her in this game because Canada trail by 1-0. We have less than 2.5 minutes remaining in the second period. Here come Canada though, and Wickenheiser has it. Wickenheiser looks to the middle, looks to Agosta. That Wickenheiser-Agosta partnership has been so productive in these games. And Mickelson has it. Out to Wickenheiser, quick turn, quick release. Good spin and shot by Wickenheiser. Not quite the power she wanted, but she had so little room to work with. It was good just to get the shot in on Vetter. Calmly out of defense by Canada. And it's Jenna going on her own, hoping to create some offense with Irwin lingering. Rougeau, the defenseman. Vetter will make the glove save.
That's an excellent job by Team USA right there. Roulette and her line buzzing Jenner. 5 USA players in front of the goal there, making it really hard. And when a shot does come through, it's from a perimeter, it's from the outside, and Vetter has no problem tracking the puck and making a big save there, keeping Canada off the board.
Gigi Marvin, defenseman. Out to the left and Duggan. The captain, Roulette, trying to get that one away, but unsuccessful in doing so. And that's a shot on Zabados, a big shot as well, and a little tap afterwards. Wasn't very well appreciated. Megan Duggan she knew that the netminder had the puck, but a little dig there on the netminder.
It was an excellent shot from Bellamy, but it was a two-player screen. Duggan and Chu in their watch. Bellamy loads up. Chu and the captain Duggan both in there. No Canadian shirts there. They got behind the defense right there. You can't leave Megan Duggan alone. She's already got a goal in this game. Zabados with a big save there under pressure.
Bellamy to Marvin. Comes back off the skate of Kelly Stack. Stack and Knight and Carpenter have been a little quieter in this second period. It's back in front now, and a great chance there for Carpenter. Carpenter, a player who's really grown throughout this tournament. Got her fair share of the points as well, and she's on the puck now trying to create something. She's in front of the net. The Stack has the puck at her stick. Stack squeezes it inside, but she was just out-muscled there. And Canada come away into the final 35 seconds of the game. It's out in front. Chance on goal from Poulin, but Vetter makes a save. And here come USA with Picard. Knight is with her. Picard, though, goes alone. They're looking for a line change, but just 20 seconds left in the period. A period which USA have seen their territorial advantage of the first period turned into a goal in the second. Megan Duggan with it, the shot past the post in the dying seconds of this middle period. Duggan plays it forward. One more big shot, maybe? Do they know that there's only 2 seconds to go? They need to get the shot off. I think the shout from the bench came for the shot to happen. Wickenheiser never got much behind it. We'll have, well, 0.1 seconds remaining.
But time to drop the puck is about it.
we do have to do it, though. Let's play by the rules.
We had just said that the Stack Knight line hadn't been as active as they were in the first period, and right away Knight comes out, nearly jams one home. Fantastic save by Zavados, who's had a few big saves in the dying moments of the second.
Well, just enough time to drop the puck and for the players to get involved with this hitting match and pushing and shoving. Bozek making sure that Wickenheiser heard her yelling all the way down the players' tunnel into the locker rooms. Wow, this has been a feisty game. At the end of the second period, USA still lead by 1-0. Canada unbeaten in their last 19 Olympic matches, going for a fourth, but they have the work to do. They trail by 1-0. We're going to the final period. And just with a sense of the dramatic, the referee there taking a little bit of time, just lingering, allowing the noise, and a penalty straight away. Watchorn goes again. That's a disaster for the start of this third period by Canada. But that's, I was going to say, the second penalty on Watchorn, but it's actually the third time that she's gone into the penalty box.
Third minor for Watchorn. And again, it's such a fine line. Kevin Dineen would have said, we need to be aggressive. We can't let them walk onto us. We can't play off them. We can't show them too much respect. But tripping right there out at your own blue line with reinforcements, not the right call for Team Canada.
It was really essential for Canada to come out of this. Oh, big shot. Carpenter from deep, but it was so important, wasn't it, for Canada to come out fast and try immediately, as we saw the bronze medal game, to come out immediately, try and get that goal back from the off, but to be short-handed from the first few seconds, that penalty coming at 40:07, 7 seconds into the period, costly moment for Canada, but they'll just have to try and kill it off for 2 minutes and regroup and restart in 2 minutes' time as they try and search for this equaliser, try and resist the temptation to get too far forward here, just kill this penalty.
Well, Bozek and Schlepper, this has an era, that first period power play for USA, where both of those defensemen had big shots, and right here, Stack in front waiting for a rebound. Excellent shot by Bozek. 5 points plus five in the tournament. An excellent Sochi performance from Bozek.
Amanda Kessel out there now on the left-hand side. Duggan and Decker with her. It's away. Kessel has it. Kessel not getting power play time with her usual line mate Coyne. But Duggan and Decker, her partners out on the ice at the moment, passing it between themselves, but just tipped away. Fortino, Irwin, Bellamy has it. A minute into the final period, 1:06 remaining on the power play for USA. An important penalty kill for Canada in red. Ward backhands it out. Good work. Hefford will put in a half-hearted chase. She knew she wasn't going to make an impression on that. As a puck comes forward, a whistle on the play.
A strange second period for Amanda Kessel. She played 6 minutes in the first period, and that second stanza, just 3:46, still yet to register a shot on goal, Amanda Kessel. Nice play there. Jam play from Brianna Decker.
Amanda Kessel, a fantastic college season for the champions. Top goal scorer with the University of Minnesota. But so many question marks about her health. She had a bad injury. But the lower body injury, right? She had right hip surgery back in 2012. Appeared to come back strongly, had a great college season, but she was rested by USA in all those warm-up matches. So she can't be 100% right. But at Kessel, we have... But then at times during this tournament, we've seen Kessel explode into matches and absolutely dominate and be the player on the ice. It'll be fascinating to see how she develops in this game. It's Carpenter. USA still on the power play for another 15 seconds or so. Bozek. Tip in front of the net from Stack. Stack out there with Carpenter and Knight. Knight gets it across. What a goal! Carpenter with the final touch. And on the power play, USA take a 2-0 lead. It's a huge goal for the Americans. Carpenter in front of the net. On the power play, the pinpoint cross shot, superb. And it was touched in off the post into the back of the net. And at 42-01, Carpenter from Knight and Stack. That line does it again, and it's 2-0 to the USA.
Stack took a hit to make a play, an excellent play. She got rubbed off on the wall, but got the puck back to Knight. Knight with a perfect saucer pass, pancakes down in front of Carpenter, makes no mistake. Nothing Zavados could do there. And Carpenter from Knight and Stack, 2-0 USA.
Well, we're talking about how costly that penalty could be. Power play goal. The penalty was almost over, but just not quite. 6 seconds remaining on the penalty kill for Canada. They couldn't eat up those last 6 seconds.
Set off the top there. You're giving the USA too many looks on the power play. Watchhorn with three minor penalties alone. Eventually, you're going to get burned. And right there, Alex Carpenter, too good a player, left alone in front. Taps it in low post. Nothing Zavados could do. But what a play by Stack. She took a hit to make a pass to Knight. Knight with a perfect... Watch Stack take a hit right here. Dishes off to Knight. Knight, perfect saucer pass. Pancakes down. And Carpenter, she knows that's a huge insurance goal for Team USA.
A lovely expression from the 19-year-old. Her fourth goal of the tournament. Her father, Bobby Carpenter, had an 18-year NHL career, but was never an Olympian. That's something his daughter has over him. Canada buzzing around, trying to get the comeback goal. Good effort on the net there by Jenna, but it's away. Fortino plays it to Rougeau. Monique Lamoureux. Lamoureux shoots from the halfway line. Center ice, the red line across the middle of the Olympic ice pad. The shot was from long range from Lamoureux, but here come Canada on the counter. 16 and a half minutes remaining in the game. Still plenty of time for Kevin Dineen and his outfit, and the Canadian team to come back, and Agosta with the shot. It's a good block in front of the net, and it's Stack really on her own, but she's making good progress down the ice. Stack tries to sweep in. She'll go behind the net, cuts it back inside, looking for Knight. Carpenter was very quick on the loose puck, battles with Agosta for it, and did well there, but Wickenheiser comes out of defence. It's on the left-hand side with Wickenheiser, the veteran. Comes round and plays it in front of the net, a scramble around the net. Vetter had to be sharp. Just under 16 minutes remaining in this game. Spooner, Wickenheiser.
Canada need a statement shift here. With 15:50 to go, they're trailing 2-0. Getting out hustled, getting out shot 20-17. And right now, the confidence high for the team in white. Wickenheiser with a nice shot. Tipped in front. Bellamy again, though. Great work defensively. But what Kevin Dineen now needs now is a statement shift. whether it's a good defensive play or just getting the puck, moving the puck well, get some confidence back for the team in red.
He's got the line out there to do it now as well with Poulin, Johnson, and Heffer, the very effective and very skilled forward line, certainly an offensive threat. Kessel and Coyne are out there on the ice with Decker. We're looking especially closely at Kessel and Coyne because they are the second line of offense for USA, and yet they've been used so little in this big gold medal match. 15:20 on the clock. The second goal in the match coming at 42:01 on the power play from Carpenter, assisted by Knight and Stack. Coyne. This is Decker. A giveaway, though, and a chance. Quick recovery, though, from Stackline. Very quick recovery by the US. There's a giveaway there. Just gave Canada something. But we'll start again right from the back. Canada doing everything they can to try and get forward here. Rougeau, Canada needs to score next. The next goal, you think, will tell us whether this is going to go USA's way or whether we really will have a grandstand finish.
Two-goal lead is a tough one. You're not far enough ahead to take your foot off the gas, and you're really only a shot away from letting the other team back in. This is an excellent play here. Jenner, not going to give up, as I mentioned. They need a statement shift. Decker, well aware of that, trying to create some offense for Canada. Right now, though, the Wickenheiser line, you got to believe they need to do something big here for Canada.
Agosta with the shot. Wickenheiser and Agosta just combining there. They need to do that. Those two can be lethal when they click. It's happened in this game a couple of times. It needs to happen more.
That's why I said a statement shift, a defensive play or a face-off win. They win the face-off there. Agosta gets activated, looking for a fourth goal of the tournament.
Nagano 98, USA gold. Ever since, it's been Canada's medal. Spooner with a good effort. Spooner had an excellent semi-final match. Shot, Spooner in front of the net. Looks for the touchdown from Ward's effort. Out of the zone by USA. That'll go to the other end of the ice, so we'll stay down at the end, guarded by Jesse Vetter, the 28-year-old. She will be under continued pressure as Canada throw everything at it. But still, there's 14:10 to go. We shouldn't underestimate the time on the clock. There's a lot of time still left in this game.
Well, we saw a bronze medal game. Sweden leading 2-0. Switzerland came back.
Johnson with that effort. A long battle along the boards for this one. It just can't find its way out of there. The referee will allow this to carry on as long as the referee can see the puck. The play continues. Now, Bozek comes out of defense. What power from the number nine. Terrific player, Bozek. 22-year-old, 1+4 in these Olympics. Yet another player who plays at the University of Minnesota. Fantastic hockey program there for women. And so many of these Olympians, and not just these sides, but some of the other nations as well, come from that university and their hockey program. Kessel. Just can't quite get that. But the long shot up the ice, it's actually on Vetter's net, so Vetter will just play that one out with their stick. So far, Canada doing quite well in trying to get back into this game. They're pinning the US down to the zone a lot, not creating so many clear-cut chances just yet, but a lot of action going from our right to left at the moment as Canada try and get this comeback goal.
Well, there'll be no quit in Team Canada. They've won all those Olympic goals for a reason.
Offside, unfortunate offside there. So we'll have to restart from a face-off. Still just under 13 minutes to go in this game. Canada have to try something. The ice staff come out to tidy up, so we'll have a chance for Kevin Dineen to talk to his troops. And the score is USA leading by 2-0. Shannon Zabados getting the start for Canada. She's been beaten twice. Vetter at the other end is riding a shutout.
Shots on goal, 20-20. Both goalies have been excellent here in the gold medal game. Kevin Dineen took over on December 17th, and you mentioned that USA took it a little easier coming into this tournament than Canada. Canada had really no chance but to play lots of exhibition games and try and get going, because Kevin Dineen had a different system, a different approach, so they were playing catch-up a little bit. So it's not that they're going to use that as an excuse, but there was a lot of work needed to be done once Kevin Dineen was relieved by the Florida Panthers and took over here for Team Canada.
It was strange as well, wasn't it, because Church pretty much had made most of the cuts already. There's some big star players like Tessa Bonhomme had been cut from the team already by the previous coach. So Dineen came in with a sort of squad that was already sort of set up for the Olympics, and he had to get used to working with them. It was a squad that was pretty much picked for him. Just one or two cuts made after Dineen came in. They had a bigger squad than this for the exhibition games and the Four Nations tournament, and they slowly eased players off the roster to finally decide on the players that came out here to Sochi to compete for the medals. And we've got a gold medal game on our hands. It's still very much game on, as that shot was knocked away by Vetter from the wide angle, the effort by Spooner. Spooner out there with Wickenheiser at the moment. Also on this line is Agosta. Agosta can be lethal if given any chances in front of the net. Canada need to be the next team on the scoreboard. They need to get back into this game. They don't have the puck, though. USA coming forward with it once again. We have just over 12 minutes to go in this game. USA leading by 2-0.
Fortino had a big hit on Duggan right there, so Canada,
with Roulette very nearly coming in there. Just Roulette was sharp there for a player who's played in all these Olympic games. A veteran just came in there and just got a little touch on Vetter.
That's exactly what I was going to say. Fortino, who led all skaters through two periods with 16 minutes and 43, a big hit. And then Roulette, the aggression. So the message from Kevin Dineen is we can't take our foot off the gas pedal. We have to be physical, and we have to jump into plays.
Just shy of 12 minutes to go, and here comes Knight. Knight pushes it forward. It's a scramble around the net. It's still loose, in fact. And Carpenter jabs away with it, but Zabados had it, and Carpenter will not get anywhere close to finding a loose puck there. The referee's whistle goes. We'll have a face-off. 11:36 remaining.
Carpenter, Knight, and Stack have been lethal. Just beats Ward to the outside. Does Knight. Carpenter has 2-3 whacks at it before Watchhorn boxes her out. Good play by Knight.
Here comes Johnson. Smooth skating, great stick handling ability. Irwin, good work from Irwin to find her teammate and Brianne Jenner with a quick shot looking for the rebound off the back of Vetter. Vetter was able to get it away though. The veteran Judy Chu plays that one up the ice and one to chase for Kendall Coyne. Chu out there now, number 13, made her debut in 2001 in time to take a place in the 2002 Salt Lake Games, just before she started her university life at Harvard. Judy Chu still out on the ice for USA, trying to provide some veteran leadership for this very young team.
Aggressive forecheck by USA. Hillary Knight followed LaRocque into the corner and all the way up the ice. USA stating their intention to keep on Canada, give them no time, no space, and no respect here with 10:20 to go.
This Knight, Carpenter, and Stack line doing a lot of heavy lifting in this final period. Here comes Agosta, though, for Canada. Agosta down on the left-hand side, plays it into the middle. Spooner can't get the touch, and it goes flashing straight across the goal mouth and out of the zone. So Canada will have to build from the back, and Fortino out to Wickenheiser. Giveaway by Wickenheiser. Kendall Coyne comes in. Great glove save by Zabados, but she drops it, and it's a second chance. It comes from Decker. Decker with the second snap at goal there. This is Amanda Kessel. Kessel. When you see a player as fast down the ice, you know it's a Kessel. Kessel comes through there, whether it's her brother Phil with the US men's team or Amanda Kessel on the US women's team. Two of the fastest skaters out here in the competition. Kessel has it again. Plays it in, it gets a little touch. Oh, it's a chance for the USA, straight inside. Quick onto the ice was Monique Lamoureux skating from the bench to take up the pass from Kessel, but it's saved by Zabados and down the other end. We have now just 9:15 remaining in this game. It's starting to become fast and furious. Canada starting to take it up a gear. USA having a little bit of joy as Canada leave a few open spaces to exploit and use that extra speed that Canada, the USA have on their team. But it's roulette to Watchorn. Watchorn needs to stay out of the penalty box. Canada need to stay out of the penalty box. They need to keep five skaters on the ice if they're to get back in the closing 9 minutes of this gold medal game. USA lead by 2-0. The goals coming at 31:57 through Duggan. Carpenter making it 2 at 42:01 on the power play. Here is Ward out of defence. Takes it easy. They'll take a line change. No, they won't. USA still have it. And here they come down on the left-hand side. It's in centre ice. Lee Steklein, just 19 years old, the youngest member of the team, but also the tallest at 6 foot. Plays that down. There's an offside call. We'll have a restart with a face-off. And a nice period of transitional play there. Canada coming back one end. USA coming back the other. Chances at both ends of the ice.
Well, Coyne, any worries about her not getting a lot of ice time in the first period? Quell there. She jumps into the play. Good shot there. Canada's going to have to open up a little bit, so you're going to see some back-and-forth hockey. USA is going to have opportunities to counterattack off the rush because Canada's going to have to bring a defenseman forward on the rush as well, trailing by 2, 8:27 to go.
Zabros thinks about coming out of her net to collect, but she'll wait for some help before doing that. Here's Megan Agosta. Fortino, the defenseman, goes up with Agosta. Agosta plays the shot in. It's a pad save by Vetter. Vetter has been making plenty of saves, but they haven't really been great chances on goal. They've been shots, but they haven't been really the quality of shot that Vetter needs to worry about too much. Here comes Agosta again. Loses the puck, though, and Bozek has it. And it's out of defence for USA. 7:45 remaining. We mentioned a few minutes ago that there's still plenty of time on the clock. Well, every minute that goes by, Canada become a little bit more desperate. Wrap around. Oh, good effort as well by Rebecca Johnson. There's no one quite there to get the final touch. And a whistle on the play as the puck bounces up. 7.5 minutes to go. Canada still need that comeback goal.
Well, 24 saves by Vetter. Excellent effort between the pipes for USA. Megan Agosta, she's come to play tonight, considered by many one of the best. Big save there by Vetter. A lot of the shots that Vetter's had to deal with are from the perimeter, and that's not because Canada can't get it going. It's because USA has played excellent in their own end. They're collapsing in front of Vetter. They're taking away time and space, and it kind of looks like every rush from Canada, it's almost a penalty kill. They go into that box, the USA, and keep everything to the perimeter. Excellent work by Team USA. Down to that woman, Katie Stone, a fantastic coach, in a position right now with 7:29 to go, enjoying a 2-goal lead. Goals from Duggan and Carpenter. And give the USA credit. They haven't given Canada much within 5 feet of the net, and Vetter has taken care of the rest with 24 saves.
Barely an empty seat in the house. A 12,000 capacity Bolshoi Ice Dome has just over 7 minutes left to enjoy this women's ice hockey gold medal game. Canada have it. Canada have just over 7 minutes left to try and get back into this gold medal game. USA, good value for their 2-0 lead. This has not come through luck or fluke. It's come through good work, and USA probably shaded the game overall. 6:45 remaining. Big battle along the boards. The referee will finally whistle that one down.
You can see lots of activity on the Canada bench. Assistant coach Goyette talking to the defense. Kevin Dineen talking to his forwards. He's going to have to break this down into chunks. There's 6:45 to go.
Poulin looking a little bit hurt on this play. Let's have a look.
Duggan's been physical all game. Takes her down. The right knee buckles a little strangely there. See Poulin on the bench. She hasn't gone to the locker room, which is good news for Canada. But he's going to have to break it down into chunks here. They need a goal before they get down to the three-minute mark. If they're down by a goal, they can pull the goalie and have a real chance to tie this up. But right now, it's 6:35 to go. It's going to have to try and break it down to one-minute shifts, one-minute segments here to try and get Canada back into it.
Here's Agosta to Wickenheiser. Agosta has it back. Agosta takes the time, gets just the right pass in there, but just behind the play, Spooner wasn't able to get in there. Back at the other end, Knight on her own, so she has to have a go. And it wasn't too far away. Watch on to Larocque. Jocelyn Larocque scored the opener against Switzerland, her only goal of the tournament so far. A late cut in Vancouver, but in for Sochi, having to come back and help out there on defence as that one popped up. Just for a moment there, I think Zabados lost sight of it. Thankfully for her, it went behind the goal. And here comes Johnson. They need something magic from Johnson. Johnson lays that one off. Can't get the attack going. It's out of play. The Canadians point to the fact that it hit the net, so they want the face-off down in the US end. Still 5.5 minutes remaining in this game. Still USA leading Canada by 2-0. Chance for the USA, just for a moment there. Sorry, that was a goal from USA, but a chance for USA a few moments ago. I think Zabados was unsighted for a few moments. The puck bounced behind. USA still pushing forward. A third goal would be a killer for Canada.
That's the Carpenter goal. Can't say enough about Kelly Stack, who took a hit from Ward to get the puck to Knight. Knight with a beautiful cross-crease pass to Carpenter. Fourth goal. Sochi 2014. She would have probably traded all the other previous three for that one, though. That's really put a dagger into Canada's hope, that insurance goal. 2-0 USA.
Canadian fans, they still
have faith, don't they? They still have belief.
And they're always so colourful as well. And they still have a men's team to cheer on to a gold medal opportunity as well. In the men's competition. Here, though, it's all about the final day of women's competition and the medals given out at the end of what so far has been a couple of great matches. This gold medal game still very much on the line, just the two goals separating the teams as Poulin pushes forward. Remember, at this stage of this game, 4 years ago, breakout chance for Knight. Just eased off the puck. Good work by Hefford. But at this stage in Vancouver, 4 years ago, it was 2-0 to Canada. USA throwing everything forward in the dying stages, very nearly pulling goals back. But Canada prevailing to win the gold medal. A gold medal which is slipping out of their fingers right now with just 4.5 minutes to go. USA still lead by those goals from Duggan and Carpenter. Here they come with Stack. Stack, who did so well to set up that second goal, assisted by Hillary Knight onto Carpenter's stick from close range. Carpenter netting.
Coin playing on that line right there. Carpenter, Coin, and Stack, a real energetic line there, really hemming Canada in their own zone, giving Knight a break on that line.
Wonder if they're just sort of mixing things up a little bit to keep it fresh out there. Coin remains out on the ice. Longer shift for her. She's now reunited with her more familiar line mates. But Canada will be trying to get this at the other end of the ice. But good work by Kessel just to keep that play alive. Really good work by the 28. But Agosta has it now. We'll try the impossible pass there, really. Agosta was not going to get it through those three American skaters to her Canadian teammate, Irwin.
There's always two or three white shirts between the pass. USA playing excellent defense.
Cutting in and scoring. Jenna's got the goal. Canada are back. 3:26 to go. But it came from nowhere. Fairly gentle stroll up the ice, then just suddenly a little extra burst of energy. And Jenna, not the player you would expect, but always a goal threat. But her first goal of the tournament. Mickelson with the assist. And somehow, Canada squeeze in a comeback goal.
It was excellent collapsing in front again by Bellamy there. So it was just a supreme effort by Jenner. There's time, there's space.
Oh, hit the knee.
So it does deflect in there off Bellamy. In her excellent defensive work, she actually causes problems for Vetter. Jenner will take it, assisted by Mickelson. But again, the USA were collapsing in front there. Canada with a lucky bounce. They'll take it. 3:26 to go, trailing by a goal.
We haven't been speaking much about Jenner, who knew coming into the tournament what a goal threat she can be. The 22-year-old pops up with what could be a vital goal for Canada. It's certainly set up quite the finish here as Vetter makes the save. 3:05 to go.
Right there, gets off Bellamy. Which, once again, they angled Canada out. She had to shoot Decker from a strange angle, Jenner rather, and it just clips the USA defender and into the net. Fortuitous bounce for Canada.
They can call a timeout, they can pull the netminder, they can try lots of strategy. Dineen needs to use all of his experience, his long NHL career. Every second of experience will come into play in the dying stages of this game as Canada try and force the overtime. Knight does nicely to bring that one down, and she'll just take some time and put that one down the ice and then leave the ice. And Fortino up towards Wickenheiser, but Forcheck, Lamoureux sisters coming on, and Duggan as well, so quick to try and get around the Canadian skaters. Here comes Larocque. Lamoureux makes a charge in and gets back to her, skates really quickly, but Spooner has got the puck. Good work by Spooner. What a drive this is by Spooner. Spooner still. Oh, so close. What a drive by Spooner. Got it back onto the forehand and squeezed it just past the post. I think Vetter got the save. Less than 2 minutes now remaining. Zabados is still in goal. She's looking over to the bench, Zabados. When will she be drawn out? When will they send on the extra skater? They could well need that extra skater. There's only 1 minute and 40 seconds left in the game. But USA have the puck. USA have the lead. 2-1. Whistle on the play. 1:35. Will we see a timeout here? Will we see Dineen rally his troops? Will we see Dineen bring out Zabados?
Bellamy on the bench. It's been a physical game. What a rush by Spooner. Inside out move. An excellent save there. And a good play by Gigi Marvin. A little bit of a stick check there. And there's Bellamy going in, shoulder first, on the bench in a bit of discomfort. Zabados is going to go to the bench.
Yeah, I'm quite surprised that Dineen didn't call a timeout here, but he took a long time making the line change. The USA coaching staff were complaining that they're taking too long, but Dineen finally got the message to Zabados to come out, so it's now all or nothing for Canada. 1:35, 95 seconds to go in the gold medal game. Johnson, an empty net. Oh, if that goes in, it hits the post. Oh. Wow, could that be a let-off for Canada? Skating in on the right-hand side, effort on goal, goes into the netting behind, will have a face-off. It would have been incredibly unlucky on Canada because I think the linesman interfered with play to allow the puck to scoot out of the zone, and it nearly went into the empty net.
Sometime the hockey gods, yeah, gets in the way there. Bat it all the way down. Oh. Off the iron, Dineen gets a reprieve. 6-on-5 continues.
Timeout,
yep. Excellent call. Well, this has had it all, hasn't it? I mean, that puck rolling all the way down to hit the post just with 1:14 to go, gives Canada new life. And that's exactly what he's going to be saying over there. Listen, girls, timeout. Let's look at the whiteboard. Let's draw up a play because we've been given a second chance here. The hockey gods have smiled. The face-off in the USA zone. The Americans have been excellent in their own zone. They've been excellent on the face-off. They've created nothing but perimeter chances for Canada. But right now, Canada, with that extra skater out there, is going to have to go hard to the net. They're going to have to get pucks quickly to the net with only 1:14 to go. And they're going to have a jam play or two because Vetter, everything from the perimeter, she's been able to stop.
The buzzer goes. And Dineen sends out his six skaters for the final effort on the USA net. 74 seconds for the gold. One goal is all that Canada need to be able to breathe again. In front, Wickenheiser. It's incredibly tense. 12,000 people in this building. It's back in front of the net. It's loose. It's there! Canada have scored! Wow! Canada and it's Poulin, the hero of Vancouver. Poulin does it again. And Canada are back. Still 55 seconds to go. The Canadian celebrations. They've tied up this game. Could we be going to sudden death overtime? What a comeback. The six skaters do it.
What a finish by Poulin. Clutch finish from Poulin. Her second goal of Sochi. Knifes it over the pad there, Vetter. But how big is that rolling puck off the post now with Zabados on the bench?
Dineen must have been boiling inside. He just strolled across the bench with his arms folded. Didn't want to react, didn't want to show emotion, but what must be going on inside of him right now? What must be going on inside of all these skaters on the ice? Well, what a finish.
Two best teams in the world. An absolutely phenomenal third period going here. An absolutely phenomenal finish. Canada with a clutch play by Poulin. As you mentioned, a hero from Vancouver, certainly a clutch goal scorer for Canada.
Wickenheiser comes down the ice, 25 seconds to go. Wickenheiser bats it in. Will we have one more chance for the USA to finish this in regulation time? LaRocque plays it away. Maybe Canada will come forward now. It's on the left-hand side. Canada have possession. They have Johnson in front of the net as well. And a chance for LaRocque to shoot. Right on the hooter. We're going to sudden death overtime. What a game. The gold medal will be decided in overtime. What a finish. What a finish to the gold medal game. Canada and USA go to overtime. The goal scorer or the goal scorer that sends the overtime goes in with the face-off and is on the puck now. It's Poulin. Poulin plays that one out to Johnson. Canada come raiding forward. Johnson shoots. It's past the post. There will be a goal. There must be a goal in this sudden death overtime. Surely there's so much open ice out there. There'll be so many chances created. You can't play it cagey in overtime. There's just not the time and space out there. Wraparound chance. Zabados makes a save. Second save by Canada. Buzzing around the net. Still, it's USA and Bellamy to Stack. Shot against the posts. Oh, close. So close. Still they come and it's in front of net. Zabados with a save. So many chances in the opening moments. Still not a minute played. Still USA come. What an opening to the overtime period we've had. This is Bellamy again. Bellamy beats it around. They need to make a line change. Up the ice. And here comes Roulette. Roulette inside. Roulette on her own. Roulette tries to jam it in. It's saved by Vetter. This is Mickelson. Megan Mickelson, the shot. Just past the post. Spooner looked for the tip in front of the goal. Here's Kendall Coyne. Decker lays it back to Coyne. Coyne hasn't got any help at all there. She's surrounded by Canadian shirts, but USA still have it. Here's a chance for Picard. Picard knocks it in. Knight behind the goal. Back in front. What a breathless opening spell we've had to this overtime period.
Both goalies in tough here. Action end to end. Chances on both sides of the puck.
Spooner tries a shot. Pad save. It's bouncing around. Knight will just try and slow things down a little bit and plays it to Gigi Marvin. Spooner with the effort on goal there. Not too far away from getting the gold goal. And that's what it will be. The goal that is scored next will secure gold. It's sudden death time. Next goal wins, and here comes Wickenheiser. Hayley Wickenheiser, number 22, the old campaigner. She played in Nagano. Incredible to believe that. Fortino goes to the ice, but Wickenheiser gets it back. A shooting opportunity is back to Fortino. Backhanded effort by the little defenseman. Glove saved by Vetter.
Plenty of offense for both teams. Here's Gigi Marvin. Just ticks the post there, that close. Kessel out front. What a glove save there. And there's Spooner. Our 24 in red has had an excellent game. 6 shots on goal in the game for Augusta. 5 for Knight. Plenty of offense on both sides of the puck, especially now 4-on-4. Plenty of ice out there.
And what that means also, the 4-on-4, is they've got to completely rip up their lines and just go out with 2 forwards and 2 defensemen every time. It's a completely different tactic in some ways. Zabados just watches that one go past the post, trickles past, and Johnson, I think Johnson and Poulin will get a lot of time out there. The youngsters and Poulin coming forward. Poulin with the shot. Wasn't too far away either. Johnson and Poulin out there on this forward line. Johnson to Poulin was how we got to this stage in the first place, because Irwin, Johnson and Poulin combined. Poulin finishing off the game time goal with 55 seconds remaining. Duggan plays that one forward. Canada have it. Canada with perhaps a slightly brighter opening. Hefford. Hefford's shot well blocked by Picard, and they'll build from the back again. USA come forward.
Good play by Picard there. Everyone's going to have to block shots. There's plenty of ice out there, so people are going to have to get into the shooting lane and the passing lane and try and help out on the defense. Picard with a good example there.
Stack. Knocks it back, and Knight has it. Knight using her size and strength. Tries to backhand it into the middle, but Canada come away. Canada seem to have the crowd on their side at the moment. Here comes Spooner. Spooner gets it behind. There was a dangerous moment there as Vetter was taken out by her own player, Marvin, and Vetter was stranded there. If the puck had fallen to Canada, it might have been a different story, but Roulette can't grab on the loose puck. Augusta loses out possession. USA have possession again, but it's a bright start to the overtime period. Not that Zabados hasn't had her work to do, but Canada looking very good on the forward rushes.
Yeah, Spooner looking very dangerous in red, and Knight and Carpenter always looking dangerous for USA.
Here comes Carpenter down on the left-hand side. She has Decker with her. It's back to Steckline. Zabados touches that one away. It has been all action. There are only 4 skaters on the ice for each side. Here comes Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser and Augusta are being paired together. Poulin and Johnson also together. Oh, wide open. Big shot. Ward went past the post, and it was a long, long time to wind up and shoot there for Ward. She didn't hit the target.
Ward had a chance in the third period. Exact same look like that. Went high as well. She's obviously got a book on Vetter to go top shelf, but she's got to hit the net there. She's got to make the goalie make a save. No sense shooting it over the net like that in overtime.
Quick line change is essential, and the USA make a line change as Canada come forward. Johnson with it. Look at Johnson. Very good work. Keeps control of the puck all the way around, but she'll be crushed against the board by Picard, and that'll allow the puck to be freed up for USA to come forward. It is breathless stuff. We're into overtime. We've played 6 minutes. There's been no goals. The next goal wins it. The next goal. Very close to coming there from the USA and Carpenter. Oh, a penalty. A penalty. This is huge. Canada will go down to three players.
Kevin Dineen not happy at all. Schlepper jumped in off the point, got herself into the play, nearly had a jam player right there, and then right here tries to bank it off Zabados. Big cross check coming in there from Catherine Ward, who was frustrated. She had a top shelf on veteran, just blasted it high. Similar play as I mentioned in the third period when they were trailing by two goals. So Catherine Ward disappointed that she missed the net. Disappointed to take that call.
I know there'll be scrutiny on any call in overtime. Referees kind of had this unwritten rule. They let things ride a little bit. But I think that you had to make the call there. She was high in on her opponent.
Oh, she absolutely took Schlepper out. I mean, it was right in front of the referee. Joy Thomas, she's called a good game. Smart play by Katie Stone. Watch Schlepper come in here, tries the bank play, fights to the net.
Oh, yes. No doubt about that.
You've got to call that. There's no body checking, per se, in the women's game. There's contact, there's rub outs, but right there, that's a full on. You could have called that charging. You could have called it female body checking. Ward officially called for cross checking. 4-on-3. Wow, this is a great opportunity. Plenty of ice for the sharpshooters of Team USA. Zabados is going to have to be supremely focused here now.
Is this make or break for the gold medal game? We're in sudden death overtime. It's 4-on-4 already, but now it's 4-on-3 because Canada have a player off. Zabados makes his first save on the penalty kill. Oh, look at this. The referee has seen something, and Lamoureux will go to the penalty box for slashing.
Yeah, I saw the slash there. I didn't think Todman would take the whistle out again. But that's what they call in the business, a makeup call right there. Bozic with the shot. Lamoureux, little bit of a touch. Stone can't believe it. Katie Stone cannot believe it. That's a makeup call. Jocelyn Lamoureux thought the puck was still active, took a slash at the pad of Zabados. 3-on-3 hockey now in overtime.
Incredible. We were talking about the extra space and the extra goal scoring opportunities on a 4-on-4. What about this? 3-on-3. And still 1:45 left on this 3-on-3.
Well, if you're Catherine Ward in the box or in the penalty box for Canada, you can take a breath because she certainly was under the gun.
Bozek offside. I don't suppose, maybe they do it in practice sometimes in scrimmages, but I don't think anyone's really had that experience of playing 3-on-3 hockey.
We play a lot of 3-on-3, but in one zone. So you'll set up board to board, 3-on-3. More of a drill to work on stick handling in close. But 3-on-3 on this Olympic size pad, you're going to have an extra tenth of a second, an extra beat to make a play. So face-off's important. USA get one there.
This is Picard. Both teams going with two defensemen, one forward on 3-on-3. Picard coming forward, offside again. So the 3-on-3 period is a hasn't really lit us up right now because there's just been two consecutive offsides and a lot of whistles and restarts.
Some of our colleagues here in press row, other commentators doing their thing today. There's a lot of people looking at each other after the first call. The second call to Lamoureux, people kind of big eyes and the offside there. A lot of us can't believe what we're witnessing, but what a game here for gold. You wouldn't want any less, would you?
Here's Wickenheiser. Wickenheiser and Augusta out there now together on the 3-on-3. Sudden death, overtime. Augusta chases that one, but didn't quite seem to have the legs as GVU Marvin was there. First of all, the converted forward playing on defense to Picard. Picard plays that one forward. This is Kelly Stack. Stack Slow build-up by the US. Line change. USA managed to get a line change away. So they got fresh skaters on the ice, and there's a chance in front of the goal. It just couldn't be. But a breakout. One-on-one. Here comes Wickenheiser. She's hauled down. Oh! Wickenheiser is hauled down. There's a penalty coming up. What will referee Topman do here? Wickenheiser was through on net.
Hillary Knight cannot believe it. The Canadian bench cannot believe it. They were calling for a penalty shot. Schlepper, puck gets into her skates. And the veteran, the superstar, Wickenheiser, off to the races. Knight.
Another look here. Just caught her heel, didn't she, Hillary Knight?
Caught the heel. Kevin Dineen was calling for a penalty shot. And it's Knight for cross-checking. Cross-checking seems to be a strange one, more of a trip there. But nevertheless, for Canada, an opportunity now. And Knight couldn't believe it. Katie Stone couldn't believe it on the USA bench. And Dineen questioning why it wasn't a penalty shot.
Can you imagine the pressure on the officials here? They'd given a penalty shot opportunity to Canada to win the gold medal.
He's screaming, penalty shot, penalty shot.
Dineen is shocked.
Katie Stone is asking about that slashing call on Lamoureux right there. I just saw her lips, Lamoureux. Like, I mean, it's a situation now. There's a lot of pressure on the officials. Officials don't want to be the decider, especially in a gold medal game in overtime. But right now, a lot of confusion on the benches. Coaches need clarification. You see Haley Wickenheiser, who was off to the races there, or so she thought, asking the officials for clarification. You can feel the tension.
Oh,
the
building, you certainly can.
The building is electricity throughout Bolshoi Ice Dome right now.
There's been more tension in the last 2 minutes, and there hasn't been any play going on whatsoever. It's the conversations and the reactions on the bench, the coaches and the players, and, well, I'm sure the officials and referee Topman would just want this to get back to 4-on-4 and be settled a fair fight, but that's not going to happen for another couple of minutes.
Well, it's huge for Canada because you can't play with two skaters, so it's a delayed call on Knight, so her 2 minutes doesn't kick in until the penalty to Lamoureux is over, so it's an extended power play now for Canada.
Judy Chu out there with Wickenheiser on the penalty kill, USA. Who would have thought we'd have this situation developing in overtime? But the penalties being racked up here. Advantage back with Canada. And here's Wickenheiser. Of course, Judy Chu, the veteran, is out there trying everything she can to stop Canada from creating a chance here. Wickenheiser goes back. Poulin shot blocked. Wickenheiser again. Touch back from Johnson. Fortino is the fourth skater out there. Here comes Fortino. Goes to Johnson. Back to Fortino. Good passing movement. Fortino, surely a shot's got to come. It's there. Poulin's done it. Poulin has scored again. Poulin wins gold for Canada. Canada have done it. They've won their fourth consecutive gold medal. What a finish. We went to overtime. We went to sudden death. And who would have thought it 4 years after Vancouver when she was the hero, the goal-scoring hero. Poulin does it again in sudden death overtime. And Canada come back from 2-0 down in this game. They win it in overtime by 3-2. What drama. What drama in Sochi at the Bolshoi Ice Dome.
Golden goal, Poulin. What a finish. Huh. Bolshoi Ice Dome is electric. Poulin, a hero in 2010, a flair for the drama in Sochi. Tears of joy for Canada.